So we have created a quiz for the MTA Java on the Hackweather website. You will get a message in the WhatsApp for that that quiz. That quiz is exactly similar to what actually the question comes, and in the exact format we have created that. Please have a look on that once the link will share with you. Let me show you how it is looks. You can see it here, right? This kind of pattern usually appear. Total 41 questions, 44 questions are there, but we have added 41 now, and but these 41 questions are really helpful for you to give you more information how the questions usually comes. For example, this one, you can see the question here, the data types are given to you, and how you will going to solve this. So 1974 comes under which data type? Short, byte, character, float. False comes under which data type? Initial data type or initial variable, sorry, comes under which data type? So how you can decide? You have to just drag and drop. Just need to read this question completely, and you have to just drag it. Like for example, I'm getting only this one as of now. Suppose that this is a Boolean data type, so I will simply drag it here. Then this is my character data type, so I will take it here. As I see F here, as I told you that whenever you see F in the value, it will be a float type. And this is something you can be byte and short, but for byte, we know the ranges is from -127 to 128, or -128 to 127, something like that. So this will not be valid. So I will going to take short, and I will submit it. So it is correct, right? I will click on continue. So I will get new question. So like this question usually comes true, false, drag and drop, filling the banks, drop down, right? So this is the pattern, and you will be see this in a Hackweather website. You can access it from the Hackweather website. I've shared with you on the chat. So I share with you on the chat, how the question comes, and you can practice on that. Probably you will get it by today, the link, and I share on the chat also, and in WhatsApp also, you will be get updated. So just practice this from here. And if any question, I will help you in solving this question, but let me start today how the question, how the Java coding is actually looks. So you can see on my Eclipse, right? In this Eclipse environment, as I told you last time itself, if you have seen the video or how we usually do the coding, right? So I told you in the form of package, first you will going to create a class, any name you can give it. This is completely user defined class, and this package also completely user defined. Package means what? Package is a collection of a Java classes. Means you can think it like a, we say in a right, a complete package is there, a complete weekend package, right? Means suppose tours and travel, they add in their website or in their ad a complete package of this one, or like a complete package of study material. So it's like a collection of a different item, right? So similarly here also the same thing. And here also the same thing is there, and you can see it here. This is the main function, and this is the variable declaration. Means how you can declare a variable here, like A, B, C, A plus B, P and Q. So how you declare a variable? Integer data type. As you know that in in this Oracle website, if you see it, I have told you here you will get the details of different variable, right? In this Oracle primitive data type, if you go, you can see the different kind of data type we have. So from there, you can easily get a syntax how to declare a variable. So integer variable, how you declare, it is similar to the like what you did in a C language. In C language, how we are declaring a variable? Integer gear one. Gear is your variable name, and this is a value that you are assigning, right? Similarly, there are different kind of variable you can declare it. You can see this, right? So based on this, you can create a code here, and like a b c, a and b is holding 10 20. If you want to do addition, you can create a variable c and assign the value of a plus b. A plus b will, what will it will give to you? 30, right? 10 plus 20, it will become 30. So you can write down like this, a plus b and assign to c. These are nothing but I'm just declaring a variable and assigning a value. There is one more variable, double data type. Double data type, I told you, it is used to hold a value more than 6 digit after a decimal. Okay, so this is a double data type. And there is a one more data type, float, which can hold less than 6 digit after decimal. Here you can see how many digit are there, almost 7 after decimal, but in float cannot hold more than 6 to 7. So double data type we use. Character, how you declare it? Char data type, char x. X is your variable of a character type. And what is value holding? Q. String, how you can define? String is another variable, means data type. S is a variable of string data type, and you are assigning this value to it. Then byte is a variable, boolean, right? And you can print it also, and you can check it, like system.out println, o, y, s. These all are the variable that I declare. You can do the operation also, p plus q. P is what? Here, this one. Q is what? This one. You can do operation here also. So let me run this code. As I told you that you can run the code from here, or you can right click here. You can go run as Java application. Both will give you the same output. So it is giving me output like system.out println o. What is the current value of o? True, right? So it is printing true. For y, it is printing false. For s, it is printing p plus q, right? For s, it is printing this one. Then for x, it is printing q, that is here, you can see. And p plus q, as I said, you p and q are these variables. So when you add these two, you will get this value. Similarly, what is a and b? A and b is 10, 20. Then w will be the sum of, w will be 13, byte variable. And as I said, you the byte variable hold a value in the range minus 127 to 128 something. Or let me see that. Or minus 128, it's something near like that. Okay, minus 128 to 127, you can see. So you can verify from this, and you have to remember also this one, because based on this only, you have to select the data type. Am I clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any question that you wanted to ask in the variable declaration part? So I'm showing you practically how you can declare a variable, and you can initialize value to it, and you can print it, you can perform operation. So suppose if they give you in the exam like this, you should be able to know which data type is hold what kind of value. You should not do mistake. Like if they ask you by data type, and you are initializing 1000, suppose a variable having a value 1000, a byte. If you run this one, let me run this. It is giving error, right? See, why it is giving error? Because it is in the range of this one, but you are trying to initialize 1000. If I remove zero and then I will run it, let's see whether it is working or what. So it is working, right? So this thing you should remember. My motive of telling you this program is just to tell you, like, you should be remember what will be the range of each data type and what value they hold. You should not assign in place of this true to capital all the true, right? Your compiler will not be able to identify that. So this thing you should be aware, like which variable hold what kind of value. And if anyone says you that they give you two variable and they says that I wanted to print multiplication of a and b, then you can do it in a two way. Either you create another variable and you print it, like you can do int z is equal to a into b. This thing you can do it, or you can directly write down here also. You can directly write down here a into b, or you can write down z here. So it is giving 200. That is 10 into 20, 200 it is giving. Similarly, Z will also give the same. So this is thing you should remember how you can do operation also. Now, anyone having any question in this, how you can declare a variable, integer, float, double. Okay, let me change this to float. If I make changes to this float, what value it will give?
Integer.
No.
Number after point.
It will give you 200.0. Why it will give you integer? Integer it will give in the case when a and b is your float and this is your integer. In that case, it will give you integer. But now I am taking as a float and my a and b are integer. So this will going to convert the z to float. That's why it is printing 200.0. But if I change it to integer, it will give me. Okay, let me, if I make changes a and b to float, it will give the same, right? And if I make changes to this z to integer and a and b to float, then it will give you integer, because see, after multiplication of a and b, it is similarly, it is just initializing the result of this a into b to z. So you need to check what kind of data type of z data type is float, right? So float hold what? Decimal value. That's why it is writing 200.0. Now is it clear to you why it is printing 200.0? Is it clear?
Yes.
Now let's see another variable declaration. This is for your increment decrement. Last time you got a lot of confusion here, so I thought to practice on this. So just let it run this program. So you just see, when I declare a variable x is equal to 10, if I run this operation, it will give me what? 11. And then I will print this x. So what value it will come? Can you tell me? First, when I print this system out print ln x plus plus, you can see here it is printing 10. Then when I print x, it is printing 11. Why it is so?
We are given the increment operator after the x.
Can you just repeat once again what you said?
Sir, post increment.
Yeah, post increment are there. So in the last class, I told you, whenever you do such operation with system.out.println, it is first going to print the value, then it will going to do the operation. So that's why it is printing 10 here first. You can see here it is printing 10. Then it is making x value to become 11. And when you are trying to check the x value currently, it is printing 11. Is it clear to you?
Yes, bro.
Okay. Now the third line, I'm doing the pre-increment. Pre-increment means it will first increase the value of x, then it will going to print. So it will become 12 now. So it is printing 12. Then what is the current value of x now? If you check it, it will going to show you 12 only. Why? Because you, in case of pre-increment, you first increment the value, then you print it. So it will going to show you 12 only. Right? See here, right? Now, when you are going to do the post increment, so in case of post increment, it will going to show you 12 only, because this is a post increment. So in case of post increment, what I said, it will going to first print the value, then it will going to do the decrement operation. So now if I check the value of x now, after this, it will going to show me 11. You can see after 12, it is giving me 11. Now, if I do pre-decrement means what? It will going to first decrement the value. So what it will become? 10. So it is printing 10. Now I'm initializing my a and b again to 10. I'm doing the operation. a plus plus b means this is my post increment plus pre increment. So what is the current value of a? 10, right? So it will simply use the 10 here, plus it will going to increment this by 11, then it is a pre increment, then it will become 12, so it has become 22. Is it clear this line what I said? Just see once what I said, try to correlate this. See a plus plus, so a plus plus value is what currently it is a post, right? So post means what? You will going to use the value first. So apne isme you just use the value 10. Okay, it become 10 now. Once you use the value 10, now it will become, now you apply the increment, post increment. So it will become 11 plus, okay, pre increment. So you are going to do the addition first. So 11 will become 12 now. So 12 and 10 will become what? 22. Now it is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you tell me the result of this one, how it will come. This line, 19 line. What is the current value of B? 10. And this is both are post increment. So here it will going to use 10 plus it will going to do the operation 11. So 10 plus 11 will become 21. But if you try to print the value of B, what it will come? B value, what it will come? Can you tell me B value after this operation?
11.
No.
12.
Yeah, 12 will come. Why? See, B value currently 10. Okay, so you will initialize 10 here. Once you use this value 10 here, it will going to increment. So it will become 11. So now you will going to use 11 here. 10 plus 11, 21. But the increment is left here, right? So B value will increment by 12. So it will going to print 12. Let me run this. So you can see 12 are coming, right? This code I will going to share with you all in the GitHub MTA Java session. I will give the folder name and I will share with you by night today. You just run on your system, make changes to this. Add more increment decrement operator and try to understand why value is not coming. Definitely two to three question will come from this and from this variable. Almost five question I'm telling you, from which this variable and value and increment and decrement, 4 or 5 question. And in the interview also they might ask you this. In pen paper round they might ask you. Obviously in industry when you will work, you might won't require this, but when you will for clearing the interview they might ask you this question. So just tell me, like, is it clear or not, so that I can go to the other questions. Is it clear to both of you? Sorry, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, okay. Now we're going to see the string data. String means what? A string is a data type that is used to hold a group of character. Okay, just like you can see here, the name, these are the student, my other student, their name is there. It, you can take any name here. In place of Monisha, you can take Java. In place of Rashi, you can take programming. Okay, so here string means what? String holds group of character, not a single character. It holds group of character. So in the group of character, I have declared a variable ABC, okay, where A is holding one string, B is holding one string, and C is holding one string. Okay, now here, Now I'm trying to do an operation on it. What operation I'm trying to do it here? See what operation I'm trying to do it here. I'm trying to just print the values. Okay, means here it is checking b. B is variable what? Programming. So it is just checking, is it blank or what? Okay, then is blank function is, these are all predefined function. Okay, these are the predefined function which are available in Java. So we are just checking, is this string is empty? You, is this string is empty? I'm asking to you. Do you see the value of this variable or is it empty?
No.
Right. So B is not empty. So it's just checking, is B variable is empty or what? So it is not empty. So it will going to give you what value? True or false? It will give you false, right? Because this is not empty. Similarly, when you are going to check for A, it will going to print you false. Let me remove this programming and check whether it is printing what. So here actually I'm trying to index, trying to access the other element, and that's why it is giving error, because see, I made B empty and I'm trying to access the index 2. That's why it is giving error. But when you run on this, you see, when I check on B is blank, it is showing true. Earlier it was showing false, right? So this is the thing. Now A dot code point at 0, right? Now if you want to check in my variable A, which element is present, means now if I wanted to check my variable A, okay, which A is holding Java, right? So what is the ASCII value of the first element? Do you know ASCII value, all of you? I have explained you earlier, right? So ASCII value of, what is the ASCII value of this element which is present at index 0? Index 0 means the element which is present at the first 0. Okay, if I do 1, then this is the first element. Okay, then I do 2, then this is 0. Means index start from 0, okay? So 0 means if I say 0 here, then it is the first element. If I say 1 here, then this is the second element. If I say 3 here, means 2 here, then this is the third element. Hope you have done work on array. So you might be aware about indexing. So I'm just trying to check what is a ASCII value of this element present at index 0 or index 2. Similarly, I was trying to find it out, the element which is now here for 0 and 2. So it is showing 74 and 118. Now if you do B dot code point before means what? For B element to index 0. So it will going to give you ASCII value for R. Before means before 2, whichever element is present, means before index 2, whichever element is present, it will going to give me ASCII value for that. So it is printing that. Okay. Now this is B dot concat 8. Concat means it will going to append the next string to just the end of this. Means just like you can see B dot concat 8. So what is B programming? So just after the G, your Java will come. You can see programming as programming end, your Java comes. If you do reverse A dot concatenate B, then it will going to become like this. As Java end, programming will come. Now if you want to find it out, what element is present at index 0? So the function that we use it is what? Caret 0. So it will going to be come like this. Similarly, if you want to find it out how many number of element are present in a, so you use length function. If any of the function is not clear, you just put the cursor over it, you will get the complete detail here. See, it is going to return true if the string is empty or contain only white space. Similarly, if you want to check it for this, you can check it. Right, index minus one, whatever index you will give, minus one ASCII value it will give. Right, similarly, concatenate you put, it will going to tell you completely what that concatenate function will going to do. And there are many more function, not only this. If you copy this, Okay, just remove this. Put the dot over it. You can see several function. You can use any of this and you can check it. Okay, there are several functions are there. You can use like this is blank, is empty, last index. So you can use any function. These are the all predefined function. So I know you won't be remember all this, but at least some of the function you go through it so that in the exam, if they ask you, you should be aware about it. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, I have a small doubt.
Yeah, please ask.
What is the difference between is blank and is empty?
Both are same. Is blank and is empty. Is blank is only just checking. Is there any blank there or is empty? So they are both we use same only. But here is empty means it will going to print like just 1 minute. Is blank will consider the space also. If you just check it here, is blank function, they will consider the space also. Like if you remove programming and put space also there, blank function will going to consider it. But this is empty function, they will not consider that. They just want, means suppose if you do not add anything, then it will going to print zero for that. See, return true if and only if length is zero. Means
okay, bro.
Okay.
I have typed something in the chat box. Whether this will give true if we are checking for is blank.
Okay, 1 minute. Let me check. You are giving one space right here. Now let's see that.
Yes, bro.
See, it is giving true. I have given one space here. As I said you, that it will going to consider the white space also. Okay, so as I have given one blank space here, even then it is telling that it is empty. So it will going to consider the white space. But if I talk about this and I give some space, let me check. It is giving me false because there is no, because it will not going to consider the space. In case of is empty will not going to consider the space.
Okay, bro.
Okay, yeah.
So whether it will, if you're removing both of the codes, it will use true, right, bro?
Yeah.
Okay, bro.
So you can practice on these three. I won't start the like.